Hey guys, it's me Anirban and back here with another brand new video on my channel. In this video, I will be doing the unboxing of this Philips induction. Actually, I have skipped the unboxing part as it is more or less similar, and also I will be giving you a short demo on how to use this induction, and also will be sharing some of my experiences after using it. And so, okay, so just sit back, relax, grab a cup of coffee, and without wasting any more time, let's get started. Told you earlier that I have skipped the unboxing part. After you remove that box, you will find this kind of packing is done, and inside you will find this kind of user manuals and all those stuffs are given. You can read them if you want, but I will also be doing a short demo and will be showing you all these things, or if you separately want to read it, you can. And this is another leaflet which this company provides us. It's of no use right now, let's keep it aside. And inside you will find the device. It's in black and gray color, and as you can see that this black surface is completely made up of ceramic, and also it's not too much light, it's quite heavy actually. And here is the cord, and let me open it and show you guys. Okay, so here is the cord. You will get a separate packing for it as well, and may remove it. Overall, this whole device looks very much premium and also very much stylish. As you can see that the color combination makes it much more beautiful. And here you get the adapter, so let's keep it aside for now. And okay, so here how it looks like, you will find a completely automated control panel. All these manual temperature I will be showing it in the demo. And here the overall thing looks quite premium. Although this device is completely made of plastic, but you will not see that it is very much cheap or something like that. It is very much premium, and the black portion is completely made up of ceramic. And here as you can see that the panel which they provide, Philips claims that this panel is completely waterproof and you will face no issues with that. And at the back side you will find this kind of exhaust, and some model number and something else is written, and some padding is also done. It's quite heavy, but it will not be very much difficulty in carrying this device, as it's quite easy to use. And overall this device looks quite premium, and because of this color combination it looks much more better in comparison to all those other devices that we get in the market. Okay, now let me show you how it works. Okay, and always try to place this kind of flat designed bowl, and try to place it at the middle of this induction. And here as you can see that a ring is done, so you have to keep it in middle of this ring only. And after that just switch on your induction, and after that you have to once click on this. Here you can see this four dots blinking, and now you have to click on this temperature. And here from here you can also reduce the temperature by clicking on this button, and now it says 100 degrees centigrade. And here, as you can see, that the motor is running and it's slowly heating up the water. Here it says that 2 minutes, that means that it will take approximately 2 minutes to heat this water, this bowl of water. Okay, so it's very much easy to use, and you can use this same technique to do any kind of warming stuffs like that. You can warm water or do anything like that, and always try to use this flat type bowl. And here, as you can see, that the water started boiling. Here from this screen you can easily identify that how much time is remaining, and on the basis of that you can even pause or turn it off if you think that it's more than enough and now I need to stop it. Just click on this button and just click on it, and it's done. And now all you need to do is just to switch off your mains. Okay, so here, as you can see, it is done. It's as simple as that. Okay, so as you can see that it is very much easy to use. After you switch on your device, then you have to click on this on and off button. You have to click on it, and it will show you four dots here. And if you press it once again, then this kind of beep sound will come, which shows that it has turned off. And again, if you click it, and it will turn on once again. Okay, so here on the left side you will find these kind of options. That is the manual option, which allows you that you can manually customize your timing as well. Here some roti or dosa something written. You can bake all those things using this option. Here it says gravy. Okay, so here are some of the other options that you can find, and this is your timer screen. Here you can find all the timings, the time remaining and all those stuffs. And here there is an option given by Philips. It is a very helpful option. It's a pressure cook option. That is, you can even use any induction pressure cooker as well on this induction as well. Okay, so from here you can even adjust the temperature, and here it is the timer. You can set a time for how much time you want to bake anything or something like that. And these are some of the levels. That is, it identifies the temperature. That is, here as you can see that here it is clearly written that 100, 130, 160, 180, 200, 220 and 240 degrees centigrade. You can manually customize them. Okay, so here as you can see that I have set it for 2 minutes, and you can do it any timer you can set. And here how you can control it. Okay, so hope you guys liked and enjoyed this video and found this video helpful. Please make sure to hit the subscribe button and share this video with all those people whom you know who are interested in buying this kind of Philips inductions for themselves. And thanks for watching, and see you guys in the next one.